is Margaret Grandison. I work primarily in watercolors and acrylics.
My name is Ray McNeice. I work primarily in plein air watercolor.
I'm associated with the Latcham Art Centre for about 35 years. So in a volunteer capacity, except for one time when I was on the interim board. I've helped with galas and beyond craft and taught classes, taken classes. It's been a big part of my life for 35 years.
I was a volunteer with the Latcham Art Center, Latcham Gallery at that time. Following that, I joined the board, the permanent board, and had sat on the board ever since. I also had a career in graphic design, so I'd pick up whatever I could do for the gallery, creating invitations and that kind of thing.
Newsletters.
Yeah, everything over the years. But it was something that we both believe very strongly in, and still do to this day.
Jack of all trades. The first painting was called Bloomington Farmhouse, and the second one is called A Purple Road. Both of these were done in acrylic in the studio during the pandemic. With everything that was going on and we were isolated, I wanted to be away from all of that negativity. So to be able to go into the studio and paint was my godsend. I love the use of color and the playfulness and just to have fun back in the studio. We'd go back there, turn on the music and just say, go away world, and to be able to play.
Both of my pieces are watercolors. The first one was plein air. Second one was based on what I would have painted in plein air had I not been afraid to be out in the winter to do it. Again, with the pandemic, we were keeping as safe as possible, but we still needed the social interaction. So we became part of an artist group in Markham who had a contingent of folk that used to do plein air, and we started working with them, knowing full well that we could social distance but still have that community that we could share. So we did an awful lot of walking through the woods and that type of thing, and we came upon a number of structures that were created, I presume, by young people that looked like shelters but were not. They were created just putting sticks and branches together, and I was intrigued by that. I wanted to play around with an awful lot more color to bring some sort of humanity and humor back to it, and joy.
During the isolation, we were challenging ourselves more because you're in the studio every day, you're painting every day, you know, you grow, you know, because every time you pick up a brush, you learn something.
As Margaret said, I think it gave us an opportunity to challenge and push one another as well. We do work collaboratively on pieces, but we're always there to inspire or to encourage each other. There's an awful lot of negativity in the world, and if you sat and watched the news every day, a lot of people were becoming extremely depressed. We had each other, we had our art, and we wanted to use that in some way to bring joy to our lives to start with, but also we became a little more active on social media, sharing our artwork. We've always shared our artwork through studio tours and things like that, but it was just a new opportunity to do that.
I felt sorry for people who, you know, maybe didn't have art or music or some kind of hobby to keep them going, to keep them occupied during that time. We also fill our house with paintings from ceiling to floor. And again, I thought, imagine living in a house with just gray walls, with nothing on the walls. I couldn't imagine that. So yeah, just to be able to fill our space, all our spaces with paint,